Students can think of the operation of addition of fractions as meaning to combine or put together. Word problems involving addition of fractions will reinforce this idea, as they will most often ask for a total amount. Let's look at some examples of this. Suppose a crystal growing experiment requires 4/6 of a small measuring cup of phosphate, I think 4/6 out here, for the first part of the experiment, and requires 3/6 of this cup of phosphate for the second part of the experiment. Now we can mentally use two of these parts to fill those in here, and we'll see we have one whole bar and one part left. Or we can place these shaded amounts end to end and see that the total amount of phosphate is 4/6 plus 3/6 equal to one whole bar. You can see one whole bar out to this point here and one part out of 6 left. That's the total amount. Or we can simply count the number of total parts. Since these parts have the same size, we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and see that there are 7 total parts. Now this is the first time we've seen this fraction with the numerator larger than the denominator, but notice that the denominator still tells the number of parts in the whole bar, and the 7 indicates the number of these parts. Now any fraction where the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator is called an improper fraction. These words were first used in the 1500s, about the middle of the 1500s, but they didn't gain acceptance until the 1800s. Like many new ideas, there was initial resistance to the idea of improper fractions. In England, such fractions are called top-heavy, a term that might help students connect to the meaning of improper fractions. So whenever we have two fractions that have the same denominator, as we have here, the bars for these fractions have the same size parts, and we can get the total number of parts merely by adding the two numerators to get the new numerator and keeping the denominator. So 4/6 plus 3/6 is equal to whole bar and 1/6, or it's equal to 7 parts total over 6. The improper fraction 7 over 6 is also the sum. Now, addition of fractions with the same denominator seems like a simple idea, especially when illustrated by a visual model. But let's look at some results from the National Assessment of Educational Progress. 74% of the 13-year-old students knew that 4/12 plus 3/12 was 7/12. So approximately 1/4 did not know the correct answer. Either these students do not understand fraction symbols, or possibly addition of fractions has been taught by a rule and students have no conceptual understanding of this operation. Let's look at another example involving fractions with different denominators. Suppose a road crew paves 3/4 of a mile on one day. That'll be represented by this bar. And 5/6 of a mile the second day. So the total for the 2 days is 3/4 plus 5/6 miles. Now, if we just add the numerators here, we get 8, and that's 8 parts. But that's misleading because these parts have a different size. So we need to replace these bars by bars having the same size parts. So we'll go for this bar here. 10 out of 12 is equal to 5 out of 6. So now we've replaced these two bars by these bars, and we have the fractions 9 over 12 plus 10 over 12. And since the fractions have the same denominator, the bars have the same size parts, we can just add the total number of parts. We get 19/12. And since a whole bar has 12 parts, we know that we have 19 parts. We've got one whole bar, and that leaves 7 parts, or 7 twelfths. So over the 2-day period, the road crew has paved 1 7/12 miles. So if two fractions have different denominators, we replace them by fractions having the same denominator. That is, by fractions whose bars have the same size parts. Let's look at an activity for getting same size parts. The students select 2 bars of a different color, like these 2 right here, and they replace these by 2 bars having the same color. So these 2 have the same shaded amount. 1/3 is the same as 2 parts out of 6 here. So now we have 1/2 plus 1/3 equal to 3/6 plus 2/6, and the parts have the same size. We add the numerators, we get the fraction 5/6. So in this activity, selecting 2 bars of a different color is like getting fractions of different denominators, and then finding bars of the same color, which have the same shaded amount here, is like getting common denominators. So activities like this will help students become accustomed to obtaining common denominators for adding fractions. Let's look at another National Assessment of Educational Progress test result. This is also for 13-year-old students. 35% were able to get the correct answer to 3/4 plus 1/2. And 33% were able to obtain the correct answer to 1/2 plus 1/3. Now this question, 1/2 plus 1/3, is given every 4 years on the National Assessment Test, so they can check these from one period to another. And almost very consistently, 1/3 of the students will get this correct, and 1/3 will write the incorrect answer of 2/5, which is obtained by just adding the numerators and adding the denominators. In this video, visual models were used to help students make sense out of the process of getting common denominators by adding 2 fractions. Students will be able to see that it doesn't make sense to get a total number of parts for 2 bars that have different sized parts. For example, one of these bars has 2 parts out of 6 shaded, and the other bar has 7 parts out of 10 shaded. The total of 9 shaded parts for these 2 bars does not give good information, since the parts of the bars have different sizes. You will see 2 games from fractionbars.com. The first is Fraction Bars Racing 2 Bars.
The player for this game is Taylor. She selects to play against the robot. She selects the green car and types her name. Then she selects the 2 bar option. Taylor turns over 2 bars and drags the race car for the total shaded amount. If she needs to determine the number of steps for either bar, it can be dragged down and compared to the 12th bar. The robot moves automatically. Very good turn for the robot, 2 whole bars. The object of this game is to reach the finish before the robot. This game is readiness for finding the sum of 2 fractions.
The second game on this website is target sums, 1 1/2 bars.
Ben clicks Start Game, types his name, and selects 1 1/2 bars option. He turns over 2 or more bars to get as close as possible to a sum of 1 1/2 without going over, and then clicks hold. Then the robot turns over bars. The sums of Ben's fractions and the robot's fractions are printed, and the player with the greater sum wins the round. The game continues until all the bars have been used.